Are you searching for a place to go on a holiday where you can find peace away from the daily hectic life? Welcome to Namsai. Where is Namsai? It is in India, but where in India? It is in Arunachal Pradesh, a northeastern state. Let us give you a peek of our Namsai.
Situated on the banks of the river Tengapani, surrounded by the lush green of the Tengapani Reserve Forest, sits the majestic Golden Pagoda. Built in the Thai or Burmese style, this beauty is the creation of over 300 architects and skilled masons all the way from Myanmar. Hard work for over 6 years bore this beautiful and enchanting fruit. Endowing peace and serenity, this golden jewel houses the relics of Lord Buddha from Thailand and Sri Lanka. The statue at the center is modeled on the Kala Buddha of the Nalanda archive. The Golden Pagoda also serves as a meditation center, and meditation workshops are conducted from time to time. It also serves as a cultural center, and artists from Myanmar and Thailand come here for cultural exchange. If you're lucky enough, you might catch a dance or drama workshop in progress. During certain times of the year, it hosts festivals like Poi Lufra, Poi Kating, Poi Khamsang, Poi Sangken, where tourists from all over the world gather to experience its grandeur and unique charm.
This statue is made purely out of bamboos, and golden colored paper sticker has been used to give it the golden look. Monks of Myanmar built it, making it the tallest bamboo-made statue in India. Eco-tourist resort is attached to the Golden Pagoda for accommodating tourists. We have 12 cottages, a dormitory for drivers. Food menu consists of Thai kham tea, Chinese and Indian cuisines. The man behind this glorious beauty is Mr. Chaunamen, the current Deputy Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh. His faith on the tourism potentiality and his interest in developing it can be seen in the care taken in creating this. The current MLA of Namsai, Mr. Chau Jingnu, takes equal interest in developing and promoting tourism in Namsai.
If you feel you need more exposure to the culture of our land, we have many homestays available throughout.
Masukha mane hun ka mai ne program homestay ni mai hau bai ga mai program na mai ye ne kene ni ye homestay ne ne pun pi nong ko nong mai ye hun hau mai u ti pin ne mai ye kun ku pa ku na ma li ye ne hau bai ti pin ne pe khung tai hau pe khau pa tai hau na pe society hau pe จองการเขาในที่แต่ห้ามแต่ปางไม่คาระอาที่อันเชียนอย่างเขาเนี่ยเขาคนอันทัวริสต์อันมาเล่มเขาที่เฮือนเขาไม่อู้ที่บินนี่ไงดีพาร์ตเมนต์เขาโปรโพสัลเขามีอะไรเขาเอ็กเซปต์กันไงเฮือนก็ไม่เนี่ยเขาไม่ได้กูน่าโฮมสเตย์เนี่ยอันหนึ่งพุทธกันไม่ได้แม่ดำเนี่ยแม่หูเป้มันเจ้าใครมาสิเขาอินเทรสเขามาไหนเนี่ยโฮมสเตย์เนี่ยสตาร์ทวัดเนี่ยเขาจะหึงไม่ขึ้นก็มาสตาร์ทวัดเนี่ยเขาจะสินะไงเขาเฮาเนี่ยมาไหนดูเนี่ยมาไหนเขาพักไตตั้งไงที่เป้มาแวรไรตี้อันเนี่ยสเปเชียลิตี้ไตเนี่ยเนี่ยเป้กว่าเนี่ยมาไหนขึ้นก็ไปตรง
For the Thai Kamti people, food forms a central part of any social occasion. It is an integral part of the culture and it is passed from one generation to the next. Different dishes are prepared for different occasions. Preparation of food during certain occasions is a social activity and it symbolizes a strong sense of community.
ขนาดวันหนึ่งไหมวัดชีมาจากทางแนวสองสามนาทีสองสามคนตานี่วันเนี่ยเอามือไม่วัดชีเฉียวสิเกลียวแกท่านเนี่ยเขาให้ไม่ปานสิตวงปานสิไงไก่เยาแกไอออกถ้าไอออกเยาแกน้ำอ้นเนี่ยเอาสิเขาไม่วัดพูดพูดสิแล้วก็นางแกจำเรียมเขาเนี่ยไปนี่แกแล้วก็ฮัลโหลวัดพูดสั่งปานหนึ่งพูดสิสุกเยาะนี่แกเมื่อเขาปรุงปีนู้นต้องมาเมื่อปีนี่แกแน่สองสามร้อยเหลืองไอ้เทศเมื่อ
It is also an effective way to preserve the Thai culture. The Thai Khamtis are mainly agriculturists. Rice is the main crop and a staple of every meal. They practice wet rice cultivation. Ginger, mustard, garlic, yam, potatoes, pumpkin, and chilies are also grown. The Thai cuisine is very diverse and it reflects their rich traditions.There are a variety of dishes and offer a range of choices to satisfy one's taste. For the Thai Khamtis, rice is quite versatile, since there are quite a few dishes made with rice. Khau lam, khau pok, different pithas, khau yaku, etc. It is even used in curries with chicken, vegetables and fish. Meat and fish is preserved through fermentation. Thai dishes are very healthy and nutritious.The dishes are mostly boiled, steamed, roasted or smoked. It contains very low amount of fat since most of the dishes do not use cooking oil. Thai Khamti dishes are very popular in the region and are loved by many. The secret behind the magical and unique taste is the use of different herbs and spices like makat, pokhoi hom, pichim khim, plokha, etc. Some of which are exclusive to the area.The Thai Khamti cuisine will not only satisfy your appetite, but will also nourish your soul and leave you craving for more.
If you are in Chongkham, look for Huan Homestay. If you are in proper Namsai, search for Hewley Homestay. Here, the menu consists of local Khamti cuisines and Indian cuisines. Have you ever had rice cooked in a bamboo? Come to Hewley Homestay and experience the taste.
The traditional attire of the Thai Khamti people are very colorful and vibrant. They are handcrafted and woven traditionally. They consist of a deep multicolored lungi called phanoi for men and deep multicolored patterned wraparound called sin, a half-sleeved colored blouse and a colored scarf for women. The married women wear a normal blouse and a black wraparound with a green patterned cloth wrapped around it, called the langwat. The men also carry a beautifully crafted sword called phanap. Both men and women carry unique and beautiful sling bags, which are colorful and have different patterns on them.
If you are male, look for Sangtini Homestay, Like any other homestays, local Khamti cuisines are available here as well. Bonus, vehicles will be provided to you to make your holiday more comfortable here.
Hello everyone, my name is Chow Tejas Khan and I'd like to welcome you to my homestay. My homestay is called Sangtini Homestay and it's located in Namsai. On offer, we have two bedrooms along with bathroom and all modern amenities. We also provide a vehicle for tourists to go around along with a guide. For food, we offer Khamti dishes, all kinds of Khamti dishes. And I'd like to welcome you to my homestay. Thank you.
The Thai Khamtis are peace-loving people and are known for their hospitable, gentle, and tolerant nature. They follow Theravada Buddhism and are known to be very religious. As a matter of fact, all of their socio-cultural activities are religiously inclined. Every Thai Khamti home has a prayer room and they pray every morning and evening. Situated on the banks of the North Hing River, close to the border with Assam, is Namsai town, the transit point to all the amazing places nearby. It is the headquarters of Namsai district. The nearest railhead is Tinsukia in Assam, and the nearest airport is Mohanbari, also in Assam. It is a major commercial hub of the region, and is slowly becoming an educational hub.
Namsai डिस्ट्रिक्ट जो पहले लू डिस्ट्रिक्ट के अंतर्गत था इन 2014 में ये बाइफर्केट होके ये कव आउट हुआ है लू डिस्ट्रिक्ट से 2014 से ये इंडिपेंडेंट डिस्ट्रिक्ट के हिस्से से वो काम कर रहा है। हमारे यहाँ के प्रतिनिधि जो है तीनों प्रतिनिधि चोनामेन जो कि प्रेजेंट डिप्टी सीएम है चो जिग्नू नामचोम जो कि यहाँ के नामसाई के एमएलए हैं और चौथे में जो उस समय जो चौखाम के प्रतिनिधि थे इन तीनों का कंट्रीब्यूशन से धीमे धीमे नामसाई जो है बढ़ते गया उन्नति के पथ में बढ़ते गया। आज जो है हमारे पास सारे जितने भी डिस्ट्रिक्ट हैं डिस्ट्रिक्ट के जितने भी हेड ऑफ ऑफिस होना चाहिए सब आ गए हैं यहाँ पर। नमसाई एक बहुत ही बेहतरीन जगह है जहाँ खमती सिंफो और तमाम जितने भी लोग हैं हमें अदर ट्राइबल्स जैसे गालो हो गए जैसे मिनियम हो गया पादम हो गया फिर मिसमीज हो गए या दूसरे जितने भी ट्राइबल्स हैं इसका ये मान के चलिए ये कि हब बन चुका है। ये तो नमसाई बहुत ही पीसफुल एरिया है बहुत ही बेहतरीन जगह है बहुत ही अच्छे प्रोडक्टिव एरिया है जहाँ एग्रीकल्चर प्रोड्यूस कहें या हॉर्टिकल्चर प्रोड्यूस कहें या दूसरे जितने भी सामान जो है इसमें हमें मिल जाता है इसमें लोकली प्रोड्यूस होती है इसमें जैसे चावल का बाउल भी आप कह सकते हैं राइस बाउल कर सकते हैं इसमें इसमें लोकल जो चावल जो है ना खामती चावल जो है ना ये सारे हिंदुस्तान में ये एक अपना पहचान बना चुकी है। अपने पास ऐसे कुछ स्थल है ऐसे कुछ जगह है जो लोग बार बार इसमें आना चाहेंगे। जैसे यहाँ से जो हम निकले हमारे पास काम मुखाम या गोल्डन पगोडा है ये एक पूरा हिंदुस्तान के लिए एक मिसाल बन चुका है। जो भी लोग यहाँ टूरिस्ट आते हैं एक बार आते हैं वो चाहते हैं कि बार बार आएं और वैसे करके ये सारे हिंदुस्तान में ये फैल गया है। फिर आप थोड़े आगे जाइए जाने के बाद फिर हमें एक जगह है चौखाम जहाँ में आपको छोटा छोटा पगोडा बहुत मिलेगा उसमें लोग उसमें टी गार्डन से भरे पड़े हैं। तो हमारे पास और छोटे छोटे बहुत सी ऐसे जगह है जहाँ में लोग आके नमसाई को देखना अगर चाहे तो देख सकते हैं। एक हो गया टूरिज्म दूसरा जो है ना ये मान के चले कि एजुकेशन टूरिज्म का भी सेंटर है क्योंकि यहाँ एजुकेशन हब ऑलमोस्ट ये बन चुकी है। जैसे हमारे पास एक बेथनी एक कॉलेज है एक हमारे महाबुद्धि कॉलेज है प्राइवेट कॉलेज है बहुत ही बेहतरीन कॉलेज है। हमारे पास एक यूनिवर्सिटी है प्राइवेट यूनिवर्सिटी है अच्छी है। फिर सरकार ने यहाँ केंद्रीय विद्यालय का भी प्रबंध किया है। सरकार ने फिर साइंस कॉलेज का यहाँ में स्थापित करने के लिए ऑलरेडी सेंक्शन कर चुके हैं। फिर हमारे पास पॉलिटेक्निक कॉलेज है यहाँ, फिर ITI इसमें बनेगी, इसमें तो एक एजुकेशन हब है और लोग यहाँ एक बार यहाँ आ जाएं तो इसमें रहना पसंद करता है, क्योंकि इसमें खाने पीने का, रहने का और जितने भी सुविधा है इसमें नमसाई में, दूसरी जगह में भी है लेकिन नमसाई एक ऐसी जगह है जिसमें लोग आके रहना पसंद करते हैं।
This Venerable Uttara Bethany College, Namsai, and it's a premier college in this district. I'm very happy that this college is doing well in its performance. And this college is affiliated to Rajiv Gandhi University, Doimukh. And we today, in our performance, we stand second in the university. And in this 3 years, three outgone batches, we are having 5 gold medals and 34 ranks. And this is one of the best thing that this college makes a difference in the university. And though there are many higher educational centers here, the main aim of our college is to bring excellence in transformative education, and we want to take up this quality education to the heights. And this is our dream, this is our main objective of running this college by the Bethany sisters. So this is one of the colleges that offers students many a chances. They have got quite many activities, not only academics, they have got co-curricular activities, and even at the state level and even outside the states, interstates, they have participated in different competitions. And these students bring up a lot of laurels to the college and making the name of the college one of the most important or the highest in the state, not only the district but in the state too. So I'm very happy that we have got good students, good faculty members, of course good management support, I suppose, and doing well, so that we bring up the students in performance and quality education. And these students are from different districts. They are from 14 districts of Arunachal Pradesh, and this institution becomes one of the places where they are practicing unity in diversity. So we are building up a borderless society being in this Venerable Uttara Bethany College, Namsai. So we are grateful to each and everyone who cooperate with us in bringing up this college to the heights. So thank you.
Myself, Kiran Chandrapora, Vice Principal in Charge, Mahabodhi Lord Buddha College, Namsai. We are here running BA, BCom and BEd courses, which are affiliated to Rajiv Gandhi University. And also we are running BA, BCom distance mode, which are also affiliated to Rajiv Gandhi University. Our college is organization based on we are developing organization based on the, say for example, we established here in the year 2013 by the motive of educating, excel and empowering the student of this area. The college is organized by Mahabodhi Society, Bangalore. The founder is our Dr. Buddharakta Bhanteji, the founder president of Mahabodhi Society, Bangalore. And we are also running Monastic Institute adjoining to this college also. And right now we have near about approximately 400 students from the catchment area as well as from Namsai locality. And that's much all. Thank you.
Namo Buddhaya. I am Bhikkhu Dhammananda from Mahabodhi Society Namsai, the in-charge monks in this center. And I am very happy to hear to teach today monks here, and we are teaching them the monastic and general subjects. In here they are studying like Hindi, English, mathematics and science, geography, GK. And in Buddhism they are studying in Pali, English, Sutta, Vinaya. And they are happy here to stay. They are learning Dhamma here and as well as general also. After 2-3 years, they are going back to Bangalore for higher studies. This is the branch, our branch from Bangalore. Bangalore is the headquarters.
এইটো আমাৰ বেম্বু প্লাই ইণ্ডাষ্ট্ৰি হয়, নাম হ'ল পাটকাই বেম্বু প্ৰাইভেট লিমিটেড, নামচাই ডিষ্ট্ৰিক্টৰ আলুবাৰীত অৱস্থিত। আমাৰ ইয়াতে দুটা কোৱালিটি প্ৰডাকশ্যন হয়, এটা হ'ল ৱাটাৰপ্ৰুফ, এটা হ'ল নন ৱাটাৰপ্ৰুফ। বেচিকেলি আমাৰ ইয়াত যিখিনি প্ৰডাকশ্যন হয় কেৰেলাত চাপ্লাই হয়, মাজে সময়ে লোকেলো বিক্ৰী কৰা হয়।
Chow Tewa Main started his political career in 1972 as an Anchal 70 member from Jeko in Sunbra in Lohit district. He retired from active politics in 2019. A dedicated and selfless leader, he gave 47 years of his life in the service of the state and the Thai Khamti community. Throughout his political career, he served the people in many capacities. In fact, he was the first MLA from the Thai Khamti community.
The roads were very bad. We never saw this black topping. Even the road from Sunpura to up to Teju, it was only on boulder. So roads were very bad, communication were very bad on the village. During our tour, during our election campaign, we used to go on foot, but within border, walking for us 10-12 miles a day was very easy those days. Not speaking of this Lohit Bridge, Tengapani Bridge was not there, Namsai Bridge was not there, even Hawaii Bridge was not there, even not speaking of this Roeng and all these places. Communication was really very bad those days. And today's generation is really, they are lucky that we have this bridge on the river Lohit, one at Sodia, one at Teju, one at Alubari, especially in Namsai. I must tell you that since there was no bridge, it was through by boat crossings were there. Truck also, loaded truck also, people also. And every year there used to be accident in the river. Once I have seen, right in front of my own eyes, the boat was coming with full load of people and one truck. that it collided inside the river with one standing tree. Then it got broke. All the passengers fell on the river. I think 3 or 5 of passengers they died there, like that. That type of incident so many times happened. Even in Digaru also. Digaru was mighty at that time. If people have not seen, Digaru is now, you know, it is very cool and calm. Those days, if you see, you cannot imagine. I mean, the wave were, say, about 20, 30 feet high. Very big, big. Man down there. But I don't know how it is. So Digaru was a great, I mean, problem for the people going to Tezu. You see, my father, my family, used to keep elephants there. We gave to government 3 elephants just to cross the river. Boat will not function, boat cannot, because of big wave. Nah? So on one elephant back, people used to cross Digaru. You cannot cross like this. If you see those, how much do you get? You know, 600 rupees per elephant per month. And in 3 elephants, we get only 1,800. Now even 600 is not even for 1 hour elephant charge. A group of tourists, this help tourism from Calcutta, they brought. I took them to Kerem village. Na? From there, I got them on the elephant back. I took them up to the for 2-3 hours on the elephant back, up to the river side of the Kamlang River. There we had lunch and from there I took them by boat up to Alubari. And they were so happy, those tourists now. Our river, they didn't speak. They were simply silently observing our scenic beauty. Those really, it was very beautiful. Can you imagine the water, they saw the water inside, they saw this. All this boulder inside. Oh, they asked me, Mr. Amin, please don't spoil it, huh? Let it be like this, it's always. It is once in a lifetime we have seen such thing.
Chow Tewa Min, along with his brother Chow Na Min, have worked tirelessly for the upliftment and all-round development of the state in general and the Thai Khamti community in particular. Another major draw for tourists is the Poi Pima. It is a festival to celebrate the Thai Khamti New Year. It usually takes place in the month of November or December. The festival brings the whole community together to participate in games, literary activities, and cultural activities. People from around the world come to witness this vibrant festival. Main attractions are the boat race, elephant race, women's 4x4 challenge, fashion show, talent competitions, and the headlining musical act. Every year it's celebrated in a grand manner, with many dignitaries gracing the occasion. This festival is not just to showcase their rich culture and traditions and their hospitality, but also to celebrate it, and through this, preserve and more importantly, to show and educate the younger generation and instill in them a sense of unity and pride for their cultural identity.
हमारे आज के मुख्य अतिथि ऑनरेबल होम मिनिस्टर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश श्री बाबा फेलिक्स जी और इनके साथ विभिन्न क्षेत्रों से आए विधायक महोदय एवं महोदया और धन्यवाद।